Aloha and mahalo, and welcome to the I Am Hawaii practice sessions, which is like oxygenation to a brain, to our spiritual brain, as it were, oxygenating it, giving it oxygen, reviving it from this incredibly whimsical, silly attempt to fail to be what it is. We're trying to fail to be what we are. And so what we do is we gradually relinquish this effort. It's only relinquishing this effort to try and be what we are not, to try and change what we are. As we relinquish the effort, the default is our true self. The default is what I am. We will symbolize what I am as the term Hawaii, which is an idyllic state. What we are is this just wonderfully idyllic condition, experience. That is what we truly are. So we were going to do some practicing here, non-dual practicing. I am neither holding on to Hawaii, nor is it slipping through my fingers, for I am Hawaii, the idyllic state. I'm neither reaching nor unreaching for Hawaii, because I am Hawaii, the idyllic state. I'm neither arriving in Hawaii, nor am I leaving Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I am neither staying in Hawaii, nor am I not staying in Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither in Hawaii, nor am I out of Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither passing through Hawaii, nor not passing through Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither discovering Hawaii, nor am I missing Hawaii, not discovering, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither stepping into Hawaii, nor am I stepping out of Hawaii, for I am always Hawaii. I'm neither embracing Hawaii, nor withdrawing from Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither accepting Hawaii nor rejecting Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither finding Hawaii nor am I losing Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither close to Hawaii nor am I far away from Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither visiting Hawaii, nor am I not visiting Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither thinking I am Hawaii, nor am I not thinking I am Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not stating that I am Hawaii, nor am I not stating that I am Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm neither professing to be Hawaii nor not professing to be Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither believing that I'm Hawaii nor am I disbelieving that I'm Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither realizing that I am Hawaii nor am I non-realizing that I'm Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I am not embodied as Hawaii, neither am I unembodied as Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither steadily Hawaii nor unsteadily Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I neither live as Hawaii nor not live as Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I neither own Hawaii nor not own Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I neither function as Hawaii nor not function as Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither above Hawaii nor below Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither a native of Hawaii, nor am I a foreigner to Hawaii, a non-native to Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither bound to Hawaii, nor am I free of Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I neither possess Hawaii, nor am I dispossessed of Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I neither awake to Hawaii, nor am I asleep. I'm neither awake to Hawaii, nor am I asleep to Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I don't feel like I'm Hawaii, nor do I feel like I'm not Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I don't own Hawaii, neither do I not own Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I do not know Hawaii, nor do I not know Hawaii. I don't know Hawaii, nor do I not know Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I don't walk upon Hawaii, nor do I not walk upon Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I don't imagine I'm Hawaii, nor do I not imagine I'm Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm not a child of Hawaii, nor am I not a child of Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm neither in Hawaii for a short time, nor am I in Hawaii for a long time. I am Hawaii. I'm neither planning to go to Hawaii, nor planning not to go to Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I neither depict Hawaii, nor do I not depict Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I neither see myself as Hawaii, nor do I not see myself as Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I neither am trying to be Hawaii, nor am I not trying to be Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm neither hoping to be Hawaii, nor am I not hoping to be Hawaii. I'm neither celebrating Hawaii, nor am I not celebrating Hawaii. I'm neither caring about Hawaii, nor not caring about Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm neither becoming Hawaii, nor am I not becoming Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm neither being Hawaii, nor am I not being Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm neither aiming to be Hawaii, nor am I not aiming to be Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not developing as Hawaii, nor am I not developing as Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not being designed as Hawaii, nor am I not being designed as Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not waiting for Hawaii, nor am I not waiting for Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm neither going towards Hawaii, nor am I going away from Hawaii, for I am Hawaii. I'm not trying to win Hawaii, I'm not trying to lose Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not trying out for the role of Hawaii, nor am I not trying out for the role of Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not established as Hawaii, nor am I disestablished as Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not growing into Hawaii. I'm not shrinking away from Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I don't frequent Hawaii. I'm not frequenting Hawaii. I'm not infrequenting Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not going back to Hawaii. I am Hawaii. I'm not Hawaii in the past. I'm not Hawaii in the present. I'm not Hawaii in the future. I am Hawaii. I am the idyllicness. I am the idyllicness. Now, all of these practices presuppose a subject and an object, as it were. Some sort of time, right? Some sort of time. some sort of, in order to be time, doesn't there not have to be a subject and an object? Tunis for time developing, doesn't that require time? Being designed, does being designed, is waiting, trying out for, growing, planning, awakening, that require possessing. How can you say you possess something if it isn't for some amount of time? So what we're doing here, we're getting oxygen to the spiritual brain of getting free of the concepts of time, practicing timelessness, where there is no question. There's no time to question anything. There's no time of any questioning. There's no time for arriving or leaving or reaching or even staying. Even staying, I'm staying here. What does that mean? For a certain amount of time. If there's no time at all, how can we say, well, we're staying someplace or we're leaving someplace or we're living here or not living here or functioning? You see, all our words are dualistic, are they not? They have to do with time. I'm waiting. I'm imagining. I'm planning. I'm believing. I'm professing, stating, celebrating, becoming. Even being. In our words, we think, well, either being or not being. Being for a length of time. So everything in our concepts, in our thought, thinking, in our words, relates to time, actually. Subconsciously, whether we know it or not, it is all built on the premise of time. Now, what seems to distract us, what distracts us from the idyllicness that we are, is time. And saying that it isn't what it is. It isn't what it is. This instant. That something needs to happen. That something needs to happen to what we are before it is what it is. Something, even an improvement, you know. We need to make it better. We need to change it. What really we're doing is we're trying to make it fail to be what it is. Okay, even if we're improving it, we're trying to make it fail to be what it is. Fail to be what it is. In other words, we're working on failure. So let us not kid ourselves. Our trouble stems entirely from our effort towards failure. To create failure in what is. So that we can say we've created something that even God can't create. So we're greater than God. So we've gone into this coma of belief in time. Belief in time is belief in failure, plain and simple. So in order for something to fail, there has to be something, right? And then a modification of that something. It's dualistic. It's tunis. It's time. At one moment, it's this way. And another moment, it's this way. And yet those moments are joined because a modification of the first moment is now present in the second moment. And that's what we call the belief in time. The moments are connected. And so a different appearance in one moment means that the appearance in another moment has been changed within that moment. It's not what it perfectly what it is in each moment. So this is the coma we've gone into. We've gone into a coma of time. Remember, in order for something to fail, there has to first be something, and then the failure of that something. And it can't be at the same instant, can it? And it can't be separate moments. It has to be somehow a process within a moment, as it were, a process taking place of the first changing, failing to be what it is. Call it a change, but it's really a failure to be what it is. we're essentially saying that the eternal moment is a failure to be the eternal moment, that it's a time moment, that within the eternal moment, time is taking place and changing the eternal moment, which is not true. It is not true at all. It is simply, we're just hallucinating something that's not there. So these exercises will get oxygen to our spiritual brain. And we may not revive right this moment, but every little bit of oxygen that we give to our spiritual knowing revives us a little bit. And we start reviving. Well, we're woozy at first, very woozy. And we slip in and out of recognition of knowing what we are. And we go back into time, the delusion of time. But every little bit we do gives us a little more to breathing, a little more breathing. We're breathing a little bit more, a little bit better, a little bit better. We have a hard time breathing the air of truth. So practices just oxygenate, get our breathing going a little bit. Yeah, a little bit more and a little bit more and a little bit more. And every little bit adds up and we start. Sometimes we get a deep breath. And then we really feel, oh yeah, I understand this. And then we go back to constricted spiritual breathing, as it were. And we cannot recall. We're all confused about time again. Okay, so I am Hawaii. Full stop. I am Hawaii. Nothing else. Just full stop right there. Nothing to be said of it. No coming and going. Finding it, losing it, realizing it, not realizing it, nothing. Just I am Hawaii. I am idyllic. I am perfectly happy. I am happiness. I am absolutely idyllic. I am the Hawaii state, as it were. That can evoke something really just, everything's just perfect. I wouldn't change anything. This is just idyllic. Just idyllic. That's what we are. We are idyllic. And I am Hawaii. I am Hawaii, full stop. I am Hawaii, full stop. I am Hawaii, full stop. All right. That's it for this practice video.